Now, an exclusive TalkTV investigation reveals that 1,230 dangerous dogs were destroyed by police forces across England and Wales in 2023. They were destroyed for being aggressive or attacking a person.
279 of the total number of seized dogs are suspected of being one of the four banned breeds in the UK. Now, these aren't just numbers. Those incidents represent a very real threat to people, sometimes resulting in tragedy. Emma Whitfield is the mother of Jack Leese, who was fatally attacked by an XL bully in 2021. I can't thank you enough for joining us this morning. If it's OK, could you just explain what happened to your son, your story?
Yeah, so it was a normal day. Jack came back from work. I'm sorry, my cat's trying to get in the shot. He came back from school. He went out to play. And about 10 minutes later, there was a knock at the door to tell me Jack had been attacked by a dog. So I got round to where he was, which was his friend's house. And it was chaos. Not long after that, police arrived and we were told then that he was fatally injured by the dog. So that was kind of the short of what happened.
Thank you so much for coming on. There's been so much said, and I've always tried to... I understand that we're a nation of dog lovers. I also understand if you have kids, when people are being attacked in the streets, when kids like yours are being fatally injured, there comes a time when people want action. There are, of course, the four banned breeds. This TalkTV exclusive investigation today is saying that nearly 1,300 dogs have been put down. Do you consider that a good thing? I believe you saw the dog being put down, is that right, that attacked your son?
I didn't see the dog put down. I saw what the dog looked like as it was trying to get out of the house, as the police were trying to get Jack. And after that, I heard the gunshots of the dog being shot and killed.
What do you say to people who say this isn't fair for dogs?
I can understand why people would say it's not fair on dogs. And I can't comment on individual cases. Like you say, there's 1,300 over the last year before October, or whatever that was. It's in that situation at that time, I can agree with what the police done. And there were people at the time who said poor dog, because the dog was killed on site. But those people didn't see that dog and how it was acting after it had killed Jack.
I can't believe how balanced you are. Extraordinary.
Emma, hold right there if you can. Thank you so much for talking to us. We're also joined by dog trainer John Allison. John, listening to that story, you know, and people arguing that, you know, poor dog, what we're actually seeing is that police are being forced to destroy last year over 1,230 dogs because they were deemed dangerous. What it seems to be is there's an escalating problem of the number of breeds that the dogs are having, that the police, sorry, are having to deal with. What do you think is going on?
So, firstly, to sit and listen to Emma speak about her son there is absolutely devastating. But as we go into our 33rd year of the Dangerous Dogs Act, the very fact that we are still discussing and adding dogs to the Dangerous Dogs Act and dealing with breed-specific legislation shows in itself that the Act is flawed, it's not fit for purpose, and we need to do more. The very fact as well that 1,300 dogs were put to sleep by police in the last year is a scary statistic. We need to do more. We need to be educating owners on the dog breeds that they're bringing into their homes. We need to educate all the way, in my belief, from the school age on how to deal with dogs, how the public deal with dogs. We also need to educate the police on how to deal with these dogs. We only need to look very recently to the incident in London where the police had to kill the two XL bullies. Now, whether you're in agreement with that or not is a different matter, but the handling of it was not done correctly. You actually seen the police release one of the dogs again due to not being able to handle them. So education is absolutely key, and we need to do much more than deal with a dog purely based on its looks.
John, thank you for joining us. And like you, listening to Emma, as a father, it leaves me cold. And I understand people's anger. I understand dog owners as well. Whether it's the Dangerous Dogs Act, whether it's licensing, whether it's training, I've spent too long talking about this subject, and people say to me it's about training. Well, if it's about training, then there need to be ramifications or rules for people to own dogs. We need to look at the dogs that are being bred to create crime and are being sold to people for the wrong reasons. There are plenty of dogs who are amazing, but when you hear Emma's story, this situation is completely unacceptable, is it not?
Absolutely. Dangerous dogs and children are just non-negotiable. We need to do more to protect the public. We need to do more to also protect dogs. Because what we need to bear in mind here is that humans, albeit, yes, we have dangerous dogs, these dogs are being created by irresponsible humans, negligent dog owners, negligent dog breeders. We need to do more to prevent it. We had a conversation not so long ago, Jeremy, where you actually turned around and agreed with me, and after it, before you believed that you may not, that we need to do more in terms of licensing. We need to have consequences for owners and breeders of dangerous dogs.
Completely.
It needs to be treated the same as any other weapon. We're not seeing it. Yes, there is legislation in place, but it is not being used, and it's not being used correctly.
John, thank you so much for laying out some of the details. Emma, thank you so much for talking to us about the absolutely horrific thing that happened to your family with such compassion. Really appreciate your time.
Thank you both for joining us.
Thank you.